From the studios at Brentwood High School, you're watching award-winning WBHS 9 News with Liza Jackson, Kyler Green, reporters Avery Allen, Anna Kate Soares, and Makai Payne. WBHS 9 News starts now.
Hello, Brentwood High School. I'm Kyler Green, and here's what's making news. Those mask exemptions are a thing in the past. A federal judge placed a temporary restraining order on Governor Bill Lee's executive order, which allows students to opt out of Williamson County's mask mandate. Now, only students with a medical or religious exemption can opt out. For everyone else, it's masks inside the building until at least January 19th. Are you a teenager looking for a job? It seems everywhere you turn is a help wanted sign. But Kai Payne has more on worker shortage.
Tennessee's unemployment rate has dropped since March to a 5% unemployment rate. Even with the drop, many jobs are seeking help.
We are very short staffed. This morning, we only had two servers, and then we had like three people call in saying they couldn't make it. So it was really busy, and customers were complaining about how the food was too slow or too cold. So yeah, it's quite an issue.
I like my job, besides sometimes I'm the only person here, and it's tough because to make a job work, you need more than just one person working. But no one wants a job at this point in life because of Corona. So I'm just trying to get more people to get a job and make more money.
With businesses in need, younger and stronger teenagers can become a big help.
Teenagers are a big help in the store because they're younger, they can move a lot quicker, and they are just more fun when it comes to a job.
I encourage teenagers to get a job because it really helps with stuff going on after you graduate high school. Good life skills will be learned, and it's a good way to earn some extra money.
If you're a teenager and willing to work, apply today. Makai Payne, BHS 9 News.
More than 65,000 people are expected in Franklin later this month. The 36th Pumpkin Fest is set for Saturday, October 30th, the day before Halloween. There will be pumpkin carving, costume contests, games for kids, arts and crafts, as well as live music. Pumpkin Fest is also free. Be sure to attend. It was canceled last year because of COVID. Maryland's Police Department recently moved into a new headquarters. Avery Allen tells us how the new location will help the department serve the city.
Earlier this year, Brentwood City officials cut the ribbon on the new headquarters for the Brentwood Police Department. The facility includes new offices, classrooms, a municipal court, and more features that will benefit the community. Police Captain James Colvin explains the impact that the new headquarters will have on the department.
Our new facility here is located in the center of the city. Our prior building was in City Hall. Our prior offices were in City Hall, and so that was on the northernmost edge of the city. So if we had to respond to something in one of the south zones, it took a lot longer for our officers to get there if they were coming from City Hall.
The new building is located on Heritage Way in Brentwood, near the Rec Center and Brentwood Library. The facility is centrally located, making it easier for police officers while on duty.
Putting us in the geographical center of the city means that we can get to calls faster. And ultimately, that's one of our number one priorities, is to get there safely and help those in need.
The headquarters provides state-of-the-art equipment and will help the department continue to serve the community.
We have rooms that are dedicated for defensive tactics. We have a room that's dedicated for our simulator, which will run officers through random scenarios. And so they have to use their de-escalation skills, and they may also have to use their weapons as well. And so we can simulate those things in a controlled environment so that hopefully when we get on the street, if we encounter something that we've trained for, we'll handle it appropriately.
The building helps the department work in close quarters and is more efficient for the entire team.
It also keeps us closer together as a department. In City Hall, we were spread out across the entire building, literally from one side to the other. In this building, you can walk down a central corridor and you can get to our administrative division, you can get to our investigative division, and you can get to our patrol division, all right here in one area in the building. So we're just closer as a department.
The new headquarters will help the department continue to serve the community for years to come. Avery Allen, WBHS 9.
Coming up, an inside look on what it takes to make a halftime show. And after that, the Brewers' chances of making the playoffs.
After filling my reputation of all beaters, saw to Taco Bell and I ordered some Gorditas.
One for more, order them, then eat them. Then head to Tubby's house for some gymnastics. Fantastic, I backflip on his beat because we running like the dingleberries on 4G. The flow colder than Papa Joe's or Domino's. Whatever. Trash wank scratched aside the nuts. Got some One Direction tickets, I should hit that up. Drive by with puppy signs plastered on the truck.
The push for the football playoffs begins tonight. Behind Davis White's 4 touchdown passes to Aaron Walton, the Bruins rolled to a 31-7 homecoming win over Hillsborough. BHS improved to 2-4 on the season. Tonight, the Bruins travel to Independence for an important region game. Brentwood is 0-2 in the region, but if they win out, they will still make the playoffs. Most of us have no idea how much time and effort it takes to put together a halftime show. Anna Kate Soares talks to the band director, Drew O'Keefe.
The atmosphere that is created at Brentwood High School's football games definitely comes down to the team, the student section, and the band. It's pretty hard to imagine any high school football game without their band.
Show up at school around like 5, put on our uniforms, and we will warm up, playing some warm-up songs, and then we'll march into the stadium. After school, from like 3 to 6:15-ish, we'll do marching band stuff on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. So every time the band is like not at a football game, they like miss us, and they wish that we were there. And we just make things more exciting and loud.
With the amount of time and effort that the band puts in, it definitely plays an impact on the stadium. Anna Kate Soares, WBHS9.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Kyler Green, and we'll see you next time on WBHS 9 News.